after the accident, they told my wife to find a nursing home that I would be on the ventilator the rest of my life. And then my, you know, if I survive that first week, my lifespan might be 5 to 10 years. So I'd say, you know, 17 years later, we kind of did a little better job.
Basically, what we're doing is measuring the angle of his head. So wherever he turns his head, the cameras and the computers measure that angle and send that angle to the wheels. Now, for acceleration and braking, we've gone to sip and puff technology. So there's a pressure sensor inside this tube. He wears the headband and he holds this in his mouth. He blows into the tube for acceleration. So when he blows in hard, it's like you're flooring the gas pedal with your foot.
I'd say Indy at 225 miles an hour is pretty special, but this is monumentally special because it's very important to me and my family, and this whole feeling of, you know, you really can do anything that you put your mind to.
Yeah.
So.
When we met him, we naturally had questions about whether someone even with his background would be able to successfully drive. And what he demonstrated first in a simulator and then behind the wheel of the Z06 is he might not be able to move from the shoulders down, but he's still one of the best drivers in the world.